With almost 500 sessions at Next 2018, it's understandable that you couldn't get to them all. So if you didn't see building scalable apps with Cloud Firestore, then stay tuned, because here is the rewind. When it comes to application development, I don't want to deal with building and maintaining infrastructure, do you? Cloud Firestore and Firebase platform lets you focus on building your application while Google Cloud is taking care of the infrastructure. We believe this enables small teams to accomplish big things with powerful yet simple tools. This starts with the choice of a wide range of Firebase SDKs for Android, iOS, and web to connect directly to Cloud Firestore. The integration with Firebase OAuth lets you set up authentication and user management in an easy way and integrates with our declarative security rules language. That allows you to control access to your data, not only based on the user, but also on the information that's stored in your database. For storing and serving your static content, you can use Firebase hosting. And finally, to run server-side logic and expand into other services on Google Cloud, Cloud Firestore is integrated with Cloud Functions. But we don't stop there. Cloud Firestore is not just a database for mobile and web applications. We also offer a full suite of server client libraries, including libraries for C#, Go, Java, Python, and PHP to enable powerful and more complex backend applications. Next, Dennis talks about what is new with Cloud Firestore. First, there are a lot of new locations that are rolling out throughout 2019, so you can store your data closest to your users. Second, there is a Datastore mode. Datastore mode allows you to use your existing applications built with Cloud Datastore client libraries on Cloud Firestore. And the best thing, your existing applications are going to be upgraded from Cloud Datastore seamlessly with no downtime once Cloud Firestore graduates to general availability. As a side note here, this will probably be the biggest live data migration with no downtime in history. Third, we are removing many of the Cloud Datastore restrictions. No more one write per second per entity group. No more ancestor-only queries for consistency. You now get strong consistency across all your data and complex queries. And no more 25 entity groups per transaction limitation. Fourth, there are a lot of new tools and services coming. Fully managed exports and imports to and from cloud storage, seamless imports of your backups into BigQuery to enable further analytics, and a flexible index management from the UI, and many more things. One more word on the Datastore versus native mode. Cloud Firestore can be used in these two different modes, but not at the same time. So you need to make a choice upfront. Datastore mode is used for backwards compatibility and high write throughput applications. Whereas native mode is best used as a backend as a service for mobile and web applications, which allows you for synchronization of state between multiple devices up to millions of concurrent users. If you want to know how some of our customers are using Cloud Firestore, then learn from Guesswork, who built the ML-driven e-commerce platform on Cloud Firestore to help companies like Zalora with product recommendations. Or Hawkin Dynamics, which focuses on analyzing sports performance with hardware and software to optimize athletic performance. And finally, Notary, who built the Next 2018 conference website and mobile app using Cloud Firestore. All of these use cases give insights into their architecture and best practices using Cloud Firestore. The second half of the talk dives into multiple awesome and exciting demos shown and walked through by Cloud Firestore engineer Kathy Lee, so please check that out. So if this sparked your interest, please watch the full talk. Links are in the description below, and don't forget to subscribe to the Google Cloud YouTube channel for more great Next Rewind content. Thank you for watching.